Johnny Quinn!
How are we doing? How are we doing? How are we doing? Apologies in advance if I look hungover. I was in my local bar drinking cocktails last night, but they don't have a shaker, so they just pour the ingredients in my fucking mouth and a killer fucking hangover, man, let me tell you. I'm a big tattoo guy. I don't know if any of you guys have tattoos. I'm collecting them at quite a rate. Five more, and I'm legally allowed to become a barista. Another five, and I can open a fucking barbershop in Fitzroy. You know? I'm 35 years old. 35 is a weird fucking age, man, because you're young enough and fit enough to enjoy rollerblading still, but you're old enough and wise enough not to fucking tell anyone that you still enjoy rollerblading. Kind of an insecure guy, insecure about my appearance, specifically my teeth. This all comes from when I was at the dentist one time and I heard him say, "Johnny, your teeth looks like a vandalized graveyard." Just much more haunting and significantly more decay. So I just yawned back and released a thousand ghosts into his face, teach him a fucking lesson. I've had a few strange jobs growing up. You know, my first job ever, I joined the Navy as a young man and went to sea. In preparation for going to sea, they give you a number and shave your head, which seems insubstantial to me. What they should really do is put an extra fucking liver in your torso, a pair of trousers that absorb urine, and a shirt the colour of vomit. It certainly would have saved me quite a lot of money, I think. Spent a lot of time in the Middle East protecting oil for us. So if you've ever spent fucking $300 putting 1/16th of a tank of fuel in your car, that's all me. You're absolutely welcome. Give it up for oil. But now, mostly, I spend a lot of my time playing Dungeons & Dragons. Any D&D fans in the house? Any D&Ds? Don't admit that, brother. There's nothing I love more than being huddled around a kitchen table with a bunch of sweaty goblins talking about stuff that just didn't happen or couldn't happen. Unfortunately, it became very, very expensive, so I've just started doing heaps of fucking cocaine instead, and that's really scratching the itch. However, that's one demon you can't slay, you know? This whole experience has been really, really fun for me, you know? Maury and Brad have managed to corral this group of adults together and fill their head with nonsense, you know, and get them into a crowd and make them bomb. So all the best in their new career at Al-Qaeda. All right, guys, thanks very much.